Previously, we created the 3D model, the material, and the animation. In this part, we're going to bring all of that we have created in Blender before to Unity. Let's open Unity now. I'm not going to discuss how we start a new project in Unity, as I assume you already know how to do this already. Now, to import Blender 3D models along with its materials and its animations to Unity is actually very easy. You simply put your Blender file inside the project's asset folder. So, you don't really need to export them to FBX manually. Unity will handle this for you. There is just one thing you need to make sure, and that is Blender software needs to be installed in your system. Why? Because Unity actually uses Blender software to import Blender scene files. I am using the same computer here, where I use both Unity and Blender, so I should be fine, inshallah. Let's copy the Blender file now. As you can see, I already prepared an empty folder in here. Open File Explorer and copy this Blender file. Browse to the project folder and then paste it in here. Okay, now notice when we go back to Unity, Unity will detect that there is a new file copied to the project folder. Unity will try to convert it into an FBX format, which is a format widely used for game creation. And Unity also creates a folder where it generates the material files based on the material's name we have in Blender. We have metal gold material, and then we have the wood material. Unity nicely converts the color from Blender material diffuse color to its material albedo color, which is nice. Let's go back to the parent folder. Now, before we drag this object onto the scene view, we need to set up the animation first. So make sure it is selected in the project panel. Go to the inspector panel. Now, for simple animation like this, we actually don't need to use Unity's mechanism system. You can check at Unity's official website to learn more about mechanism. Basically, in this tutorial, I'm going to use the old or the legacy animation system. Mechanism is great, but for simple animation like this, it can be an overkill. So to set our 3D model to use legacy animation system, we can go to the Rig tab. In the Animation Type option, we can see it is defaulted to Generic. If we click on this pull-down list, we can see that Unity actually supports three systems: Generic, Legacy, and Humanoid. I believe both Generic and Humanoid used mechanism system. So we should pick this Legacy option up here. Click the Apply button, or otherwise the changes will not take effect. Okay, now go to the Animation tab. Notice currently we only have one animation or clip, which is this default take as the name. Let's rename this first animation to opening. Then for this opening animation, we want to assign Blender's animation from frame 0 to frame 20. Again, as we mentioned earlier, 0 in here means 1 in Blender, and 20 in here means 21 in Blender. Next, click this plus button to create the second clip. Rename it to closing. And for the closing animation, we need to input 21 as the start frame and then 40 as the end frame. We can preview the animation down here. This is for closing animation. And this is for opening animation. Okay, so we have these two animations in here. Now these changes need to be applied by clicking this Apply button. By clicking this Apply button, Unity will generate two animation clip files which are for opening and for closing. So let's hit Apply in here. Now notice, if we click this caret button in here, we have this hierarchical structure. We can see body object in here and the cover object. And down here, we have the animation clips we have created before when we hit the Apply button in the animation panel. Now, we are ready to use this object in our scene. To put this into our scene, simply click and drag this treasure chest object to the scene view like this. Okay, now that we have the object in the scene, notice that it is not placed exactly at the center. We can center this object by typing 0 to these coordinate input fields one by one. But there is a faster way to do this, and that will be clicking on this option panel, which looks like a gear symbol, and then click on the reset option in here. As we can see, now the object is visible in the center of the camera, because the camera is actually looking at the center of the 3D world by default. Okay, now let's zoom out in the scene view to see our object and the camera. And let's move the treasure chest object so it is placed closer to the camera. Also, let's move this a bit to the left so we can see the side of it. Okay, now we can see the whole treasure chest better. Next, we want to add interactivity to the chest object using a plugin or an editor extension asset called Playmaker. Now, I assume that you already purchased this asset, as this is a paid asset, not a free one, and that you already downloaded it and installed it in your project. If you correctly installed it, you will have Playmaker menu up here, and inside the menu, if you click on this Playmaker editor, you will have this window, okay? Now, because we want to add clicking behavior on this object, we need to add collider on it. So let's zoom in a bit in the scene view. We can press F to zoom extend a selected object. Now while the object is still selected, go to the inspector panel and click Add Component. Type box and Unity will show several components that have box word on it. Of course, we don't want the 2D collider as our object is a 3D object. So double click on this box collider component. Now you might notice that the box collider is not perfectly matched the size of the chest object. We can edit the collider by clicking this button. We can see the faces of the box collider, just like we see object in the edit mode inside Blender. So we can grab this face and drag this up like this, then this face down here to about this position. Another way to do this is by dragging this value. Oops, sorry, this is for the center position. It should be this one, the size. We can drag the X label in here to change the X dimension of the collider. Next, we want to make our chest only detect collision or click events and not actually contributing to the physics simulation. To do that, we can turn on this Is Trigger option in here. So again, if this is turned on, then if later a physics object falls onto this object, it will just pass through it like it doesn't even exist. But if we set this is trigger off, when a physics object drops on it, it will stay there or bounce off. For now, we turn on is trigger option, as we don't have any physics simulation going on in our scene, and it is less taxing on the system performance this way. Notice also on this object, Unity already added this animation component for us, which is already include our two animation clips, opening and closing. Now notice we have this play automatically option in here. If we have this turned on, when we hit the play button, it will play the opening animation as soon as the game starts, which is not what we want. So make sure this option is off. Okay? After this is done, we can start adding interaction with Playmaker. As always, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, give a thumbs up if you like the video, and give a thumbs down if you don't like the video. See you in the next part. Wassalamualaikum.